Who do you spend most of your time connecting with? Out of the people in your life, who do you allow to have the biggest influence on your mind, on your thinking, on the way you see yourself, on the way you see others, on the way that you see the world? Who do you allow to influence this? Maybe it's not a certain person. Maybe it's a group of people. Maybe it's a collective. Maybe it's a group of friends online. Maybe it's someone in the workplace or someone that you live with, someone in your family. Who do you allow, my friends? Who do you allow to control that thinking, to influence that thinking? Today, we're with Napoleon Hill once again, and he's going to be introducing us to the mastermind concept. The mastermind concept is when you have at least one person, sometimes a few more than one person, but they're the right people. The right people are so important that we connect with the right people. Because the ideas that they share with us go on to change our lives. But when we're surrounding ourselves with the wrong people, oh, it takes you down a dark path. You can also be taken down a dark path when you're not surrounding yourself with anyone at all. Because then you're stuck in an isolated zone where it's all on you. And you don't have any good coming in, right? Then again, sometimes taking a break from everything can be good for us. Let's get started, my friends. We're back in action with Napoleon Hill. Let's learn about the mastermind concept.
How do you do? I'm very happy to have this personal visit with you. Won't you be seated, please? We come now to the second of the 17 principles which lead to the master key with which you may open the door to the attainment of your definite major purpose in life. This principle of success is called the mastermind principle. I want you to understand the nature of the mastermind principle because you must use it before you can take possession of the master key. An understandable definition of the mastermind is this. It consists of two or more people who work in perfect harmony for the attainment of a definite purpose. Now, here are some interesting facts about the mastermind, which...
So two or more people that are working together for the same purpose, right? Two or more people, you have to have at least one person. And you and that person say, we know where we're going to go. We're going there together. And on the way there, we're going to share what we learn with each other, all right? And it can be more than two people. It can be three, four. You could have it, I think 10 is the most, or 12, something like that. But you share information with each other, right? You share what you learn. You make mistakes, you tell them about it so they don't make the mistakes as well, right? And when you have that and you each relate to each other, you each understand each other, it just builds you up, it helps you because you have people who relate to you and understand you. It's amazing, my friends. It's absolutely beautiful.
Give you an idea of how important it is and how necessary that you embrace this principle and make use of it in attaining success in your chosen occupation.
And Napoleon Hill said it's required. It's a required part to obtain the master key is for you to have your mastermind with at least one person that you can go to and you can discuss your goals with because they have the exact same goals.
First of all, it is the principle through which you may borrow and use the education, the experience, the influence, and perhaps the capital of other people in carrying out your own plans in life. It is the principle through which you can accomplish in 1 year more than you could accomplish without it in a lifetime if you depended entirely upon your own efforts for success.
So right here he says, with the mastermind, with the power of the mastermind, the right mastermind, you will accomplish more in 1 year than you would in an entire lifetime without help from those individuals who are going to help you. That's powerful stuff. Within 1 year. Wow.
And I have heard well-informed Bible students say that the first known application of the mastermind was that which existed between the Nazarene and his 12 disciples. Of one fact, I am absolutely sure. When you form a true mastermind alliance with others and work with them in a spirit of perfect harmony, you can draw freely upon the spiritual forces within you in carrying out your plans and desires. I also know that the mastermind principle can give you absolute protection against failure, provided always that your purpose is in using this principle is beneficial to all whom you influence.
So when you're in the mastermind, you've got with you. You can't fail because the others in there, your other one, your other two, your three, however many, they're not going to let you fail, right? And when you start feeling like, man, this is getting difficult, I don't know if I can keep, things aren't going right, right? And normally you could just say, oh, I'm not going to try anymore. They're not going to let you do that. They're going to say, no, you're not going to give up. They're going to say, have you tried this? Have you tried that? You say, oh, you know what? No, I haven't tried it that way. All right, well, let's try this then. Let's see how this. And they're going to make sure that you don't give up. All right? Yes. Yes. The mastermind. This is good.
In my research, while organizing the Science of Success, I had the collaboration of practically every outstanding, successful man this country has produced during the past 50 years. And I can tell you definitely that their success was due in the main to their knowledge and application of the mastermind principle. I wish also to call your attention to the fact that our great American way of life and our unmatchable system of free enterprise have been built upon the mastermind principle. The greatest document ever conceived by the mind of man is a perfect example of the mastermind principle in action. It is the Declaration of Independence and the best evidence of the importance of maintaining perfect harmony in a mastermind alliance may be found in the fact that the 56 men who signed the Declaration of Independence knew full well that it might turn out to be either a license of freedom for all mankind or a death warrant which would cause each of the signers to be hanged. Now let us see how the mastermind principle has brought success to people whom we all know. First, consider when Kate Smith began her career as a singer. She had difficulty in earning enough from her singing to pay her living expenses. And she perhaps never would have made her singing pay if she had not discovered and applied the mastermind principle, which gave her access to the master key to success when she formed a mastermind alliance with Ted Collins. And according to a report I saw in Reader's Digest, Kate Smith has earned upwards of $30 million.
So he's talking about opportunity, the opportunity that comes along with that as well, right? When you have these goals, things you want to obtain, things you want to achieve, and you've got others who are on the exact same path, a lot of times they're going to introduce you to opportunity. A lot of times they're going to offer you opportunity you wouldn't have found outside of that. That's cool too. That's another plus. It's just a huge plus of having those individuals that you can connect with, that you can be in touch with, that you can work together with and help each other and teach each other, inspire each other, and hold each other up when one of you is feeling down. Lift them up. And get this, here's another cool thing. When they really make it, you're making it too, because you're right there by their side, right? And vice versa. You really make it, they're right there by your side. You take care of one another. You take care of each other. Yes.
And she is still in the upper brackets of income. Two, I remember when Edgar Bergen and that cute little block of wood known as Charlie McCarthy used to play anywhere they could get an engagement. And I rather suspect that often all they got for their services was a meal. But Edgar Bergen is a smart man in the field of entertainment. So he formed a mastermind alliance which introduced him and Charlie to millions of people by radio and television. And I suspect he is not concerned about money any longer. And you may be surprised when I tell you that the great Ford Industrial Empire started with the formation of a mastermind alliance between Henry Ford and his wife.
Wow.
At the beginning of his career, Henry Ford was shy and lacking in self-confidence. It was Mrs. Ford who inspired Henry Ford with the faith and the courage to go ahead with the perfection of his horseless carriage. Although his relatives and neighbors generally tried to discourage him from wasting his time with the contraption, as they called it.
So Henry Ford's friends and neighbors tried to tell him to stop wasting his time with the horseless contraption? Henry Ford? Wow. Oh my goodness. That we're talking about Henry Ford. Wow. Hey, next time someone starts laughing at you, telling you you're stupid, you're dumb for what you're trying to do, tell them about Henry Ford, all right? And Henry Ford had his wife, though, right? They had this mastermind group, the two of them. She helped him. She inspired him. She built him up, right? And hey, it really worked out for them, didn't it?
Right here, may I offer a word of advice to the wives? You have it within your power to make or break your husband. By forming a mastermind working alliance with him, You can inspire him to aim high and to carry on when the going is hard until he achieves his aims. I have often observed that somewhere in the background of every successful man I have ever known is evidence of the influence of a woman. Well, generally speaking, this woman is a wife, but I have also noticed that where the wife fails to form a mastermind alliance with her husband and neglects to serve as an inspiration to him, some other woman often is nearby and looking for that very opportunity. Four, the Federation of States, known as the United States of America, is the richest and the most powerful nation civilization has yet produced. And the secret of our strength and riches consists in our form of government through which all our states function in a spirit of harmony based on the mastermind principle, through a central federal government located at Washington. And now a word to you personally. If you work for a salary or wages, you have a marvelous opportunity to promote yourself into a higher income and a more responsible position by forming a mastermind alliance with your associate workers, including the management. In my next visit, I will give you further instructions on how to apply the mastermind principle so as to increase your own income and promote yourself to a higher position with the full cooperation of your management. Yes, that is correct.
So that's real interesting there. He says you can even have mastermind connections with your coworkers, with your management. You can have mastermind connections with them, you know. Throughout the jobs that I've had, like the jobs that, you know, like hourly jobs, not very good jobs, I've never felt like that in the jobs that I had, that, you know, I can connect with management like that. It was always because those weren't good jobs, right? Those were just silly stuff that you don't care about. You don't get paid enough to care about them, right? So that's interesting. I bet this applies much more to jobs with more meaning behind them. In the past, I did things. I did security. I was a mover. I did a bunch of things like that. So, yeah. Real interesting, though, that you can have that with your management as well as your coworkers. That's cool. That's
I will show you how to write your own price tag, fix your own wages, establish your own working hours, and give yourself financial independence.
Let's do it.
Right now, I want you to do three things before our next visit. First, decide definitely where you wish to be and what you wish to be doing during the next 3 years.
During the next 3 years. All right, remember we talked about that yesterday, definiteness of purpose, right? Did you get your book? Did you write it out in the book? Did you write it out? Did you write down what you're willing to give for it? What you want, what you're going to do, and what you're willing to trade for it? I wrote in here, I know what I want. And what am I willing to give? I'm willing to give 16 hours a day, every day. I'm willing to give that to get what I want. I have few things that I'm gonna have. And I didn't say I'm going to get these. I said I am this. I have this because I'm training myself, all right? I'm training myself right now to be in that frame, to be in that state of mind so that I can act in that state of mind, right? We don't want to put it off and say it will be here one day. We want to say it's here now, and we train ourselves and we train our minds to act in that way, right? The best way to become that is to become it right now, right? By learning to act that now, be that. You're in control. You let outside sources tell you who you are, what you are. You can live like that your whole life. You take control. We talked about that so much yesterday. Take control of your mind. It's your mind. Damn it. It's your mind. You control it. Not anybody else. It's you. The power is within you. I hope that you feel it now. I hope you're starting to feel it if you haven't felt it yet. The power is in you, my friend.
And second, decide how much money you desire to be making and what you are going to do to earn it. And third, form a mastermind alliance with at least one person in your immediate family and at least one other person among those to whom you are selling your services.
That's right. You can have multiple masterminds. You can have multiple mastermind groups, right? I feel that's how I am now. I have a few individuals that I really connect with one-on-one, and we're on the same mindset and we grow together. I don't have a group, though, a group of people. It's individuals that I connect with. Interesting stuff, though.
By taking these three steps, you will have gone a long way toward appropriating the great master key to success. There is no such thing as something for nothing. Everything, including your personal success, has a price that must be paid.
Okay.
And the only price you are requested to pay for the present is the effort necessary to do three simple things that I have suggested. Now, before you begin to take the three steps I have suggested, there is one important fact I wish you to remember, and it is this. Control your mental attitude and make yourself friendly and agreeable with everyone with whom you are closely associated.
Control your mental attitude. Make yourself friendly and agreeable with everyone who you're closely associated with, who you're trying to work with. Don't be a jerk to them. You be a jerk to people, they're not gonna vibe with you. You can't grow together and learn together, right? You want to be loved in your field by those who you want to work with, that you want to be associated with. Treat them right. Treat them right. Show them respect so they can give you the same in return, right?
If you expect friendly cooperation in return. Indifference cannot create a mastermind alliance for you. A negative mental attitude can bring you nothing but failure. Remember always, you are where you are and what you are because of your mental attitude in which you relate yourself to other people.
You are where you are and who you are because of your mental attitude with which you relate yourself to other people. Oh, wow. Let's think about that here. You are where you are and who you are because of your mental attitude with which you relate yourself to other people. Which is why we don't want to relate ourselves to others as in we're less than others. We're inferior. We're not good enough. We're not this. We're not that, right? We're in control. You're in control. It's good.
Remember also, your mental attitude is the one and the only thing over which you have complete control.
Your attitude.
Success is something which has to be planned, and success is something which has to be earned in advance. True, there is such a thing as luck, but just remember that luck is something you can create for yourself if you know the rules and follow them just as I give them to you. Remember, too, that success in the higher brackets of achievement is something that can be had only by taking others along with you.
And only by taking others along with you. Yes, you can't do it all by yourself, right? Hey, think about the video games. Think about the dungeons you do. When you go in that dungeon, right, you gotta have the team together, right? Because the team, the power of the team is much stronger than the power of the one. You can't take out that big boss all by yourself. You gotta have the healer, right? You gotta have the DPS, right? You gotta have these different, y'all coming together to work together. There's so much more power in the team than in one, right? Yeah, that's good stuff. That's good stuff. You have to have a team. Work together. Yeah.
And the best definition of success, which I know, is this. Success is the knowledge with which to get whatever you want from life without violating the rights of others and by helping others to acquire it. There is a known formula for the attainment of success, and it is as definite and certain as are the rules of mathematics or the principles of science. My purpose in these visits is to bring you that formula in simple terms that you can understand and apply. But I can never give you that for which you are not ready.
Remember the key. You will be given the key when you're ready for the key, but not before then.
If you are ready to advance into the higher brackets of success, you will recognize this fact by your willingness to follow the simple instructions I shall give you as we go along. If Kate Smith had not been ready for success when she formed a mastermind alliance with Ted Collins, he couldn't have brought her success. This thing called success is a...
You have to be ready for it, is what he's saying. You have to be ready for it. If you're not ready for it, you don't take the actions towards it because you're not actually ready for it. Damn, do you understand that? If you're not ready for it, you don't take the actions for it. You weren't ready for it. You're ready for it. That's when you take the actions towards it. Only once you're ready for it. Wow.
A very profound and interesting thing because the line of demarcation between success and failure is so slight that it is often hard to tell where one ends and the other begins. For example, in my association with the late Henry Ford, I recognize that he had thousands of people working for him who had much more education than he, more magnetic personalities, more ability to make friends, and a much better chance of succeeding than Mr. Ford had when he was working for wages. But Mr. Ford had one simple quality the others who worked for him did not possess.
What was that?
The same quality I will clearly describe for you in my future visits with you. Meanwhile, I would be interested in knowing if you can describe this one simple quality Henry Ford possessed, which made him the greatest industrialist this nation has ever produced. In my next visit, I will give you a definite clue as to the success quality which helped Henry Ford spread his influence throughout the world and make himself richer than Croesus, despite the fact that he had only a meager common school education. Until then, please be of good cheer, will you? And just remember that your only real limitation is the one you accept and set up in your own mind.
Your only real limitation is the one you accept and set up in your own mind. That's the only limitation, is what you accept and set up in your own mind. Wow. I'll see you on next episode, part 3. We'll talk about Henry Ford. We'll learn what Napoleon Hill's going to tell us set Henry Ford apart from everyone that worked for him. Oh my goodness. We're on the way, you guys. We're on the way. Hey, I'll put the playlist over here. All right. Got the playlist there. This is part 2. I'll see you next time on part 3. Follow Bay Shaman on Instagram. I post that good motivational content every single day. And I'll see you very, very soon, my friends. Peace, love, and blessings. I can't wait for us all to get exactly what we want to, which we will. All right. We need to believe in each other. I'll see you so soon.